Oh, Lydia, you've gotten up. Sorry, I hope I didn't wake you while I stepped over you when I got up.
What can I get you? Mead? Wine?
No, I'm actually quite okay. I just finished my little boiled cream treat here. Don't...
You want a drink?
No thanks. Can you tell me about the wedding ring?
Every Argonian wedding proposal band is supposed to have three flawless amethysts as part of their design.
Oh, that's right. I'm supposed
to
find you
a... gems. The ones on the outside represent the couple to be married. One for the husband, one for the wife. The amethyst in the center represents the Hist, the entity that all Argonians consider a sacred part of our lives.
Gotcha. Yeah, I kind of, I admittedly kind of forgotten about that. I'm actually okay. I probably could use a refill, so let's go ahead and do that.
Of course.
And I'll actually be on my way. Lydia, we've got some, we got some more places to explore in Riften, I'm sorry to say, and then we'll be on our way.
Look, I already said Shadra doesn't owe me a thing, so get off my back.
Okay, sorry, you were just kind of looking at me. You know what, Lydia? I thought the morning might bring a finer smell to this wretched town. I mean, oh, sorry. I hope she didn't hear me. Lydia, you're in her way, and you're kind of staring at the door.
Can't you bother me at my armor stand in the market? Or are you that desperate for training?
No, I wasn't. Good grief. Oh, I'm ready to get out of this town. Lydia, I just want to go talk to this orphanage over here. Oh, there's...
God, won't take the time.
What's wrong?
Yes?
Are you okay?
Huh? Well, not really.
Yeah, you seem drunk. Well, what's wrong?
Well, I was taking an evening walk like I always do, and I saw some men outside the Echo Deep Mine. The thing is, they look like mercenaries, up to no good.
You don't say. And what makes you think that about them?
I've never seen them around here, and they look real tough. In addition, the Echo Deep Mines are not a place people go. There are myths about it.
Right. What exactly are the myths?
All sorts of stories. Some say it's haunted by ghosts. Some say a wealthy bandit lord hides out in it, quietly contributing to the crime in Riften.
Really?
Some people even say that deep within the mines there are Dwemer ruins, full of all sorts of automatons, just waiting to slay whoever enters.
Interesting. So what's the problem?
On my way back from my walk, I passed mine entrance again. I heard all sorts of horrific noises. I reckon something happened to those men. Anyone going to those mines is up to no good. Now, I've asked a guard to take a look, but they just ignore me. I need someone to see what's happened. Would you go look for me? Please, if they're planning something, the city guard needs to know. Please, go check for me.
I don't know why I'm offering to help this guy, but... Sure, I'm looking for adventure anyways. Maybe there's a word wall there.
Finally, thank you. I'll mark it down on your map. Just be careful. We still don't know what's in there.
Right. Let's see where that quest is. Shadowstone, the Fort Echo Deep Mine. Okay. Lydia, I'm sorry to say, though, that before we do that... Oops. Remove that. Before we do that... What is the button? Middle click? Just this? Okay, there we go. We're gonna have to pay another visit to Falkreath. I gotta get this ring off my finger.
Please, let me know when you figure out what those men were up to.
Yes, yes, please. I will.
Please,
all right, so let's find this orphanage. I think it's... That's probably it right there. We've still got more places to go, and I figure my spirits need some lifting. Maybe it... I'm talking to you. Are you listening? Hello?
Those who shirk their duties will get an extra beating. Do I make myself clear?
Yes, Grelid.
And one more thing. I will hear no more talk of adoptions. None of you riffraff is getting adopted, ever. Nobody needs you. Nobody wants you. That, my darlings, is why you're here. Why you will always be here until the day you come of age and get thrown into that wide, horrible world. Now, what do you all say?
We love you, girl. Thank you for your kindness.
That's better. Now scurry off, my little gutter snipes.
Oh my goodness. Lydia, I've found the worst of the bunch. Hi. Is she wacko?
You really shouldn't be here.
She was so mad. I got double.
Sadly, yes. Even the townsfolk have taken to calling her Grelod the Kind. Her very existence has become something of a running joke. Grelod runs this orphanage because she's old and set in her ways and doesn't know any other life. These children need love and comfort. I try. But I'm sorry. You should go. The children aren't up for adoption, and it's cruel to get their hopes up. Besides, Grelod hates visitors.
Good. I would like it for her to be upset. Could I adopt one of the kids, though?
I'm sorry, no. Grelod is the headmistress here, and she's decided not to allow any adoptions right now. I wish things were otherwise. All of these children deserve a better home.
I'll say.
But there's nothing I can do.
Interesting. I'm gonna go talk to this Grelod.
I hate it here. Grelod the Kind is the meanest person in all of Skyrim.
Grelod? Where did she go? Alright, well, there's books here. Coin purse. I ought to steal from her. Woodcutter's wife. Where did she go? What? What? Lydia, there are shackles in here.
Come to get yourself a pin?
Oh, there she is.
You're at a lock.
What do you want? You have no business being in here.
I sure do.
Especially not since Aventus took off.
Riff-raff. That's all you Riften people are.
You're serious. You have nothing you want. You don't want to hear me say anything.
I'm strong and quick and can do any chore you want.
I bet you are.
Hmm?
Who was Aventus? I guess she was starting to say something about Aventus.
A little boy who lived here. Aventus Saratina. He was nice, but really quiet and sad because his mother just died. He ran away, back home to Windhelm. Samuel told me he's trying to get some murderer people to come here and cook Threadland.
Huh.
I really hope he does.
Oh my goodness.
Until next time.
Poor kids. What do the boys have to say?
Mister, I do hope Mommy and Father come to get me soon. Ever since that Aventus boy left, Grelod has been so angry.
I'm not going to ask who Aventus is. I get that.
Need something?
There's another entrance? Oh. This is just some sort of courtyard area. Butterflies, though. Can I get them? Got it. How about that one? Got it. Is there anything secret back here? No, this is just a nice little courtyard area. Well, all right then. All right, Lydia, let
some stranger just hanging around.
Let's leave these folks
not
be.
That I care.
For now.
Why someone like you want to hang around a place like this?
To be honest, I don't, kid. I really don't. I really want to get going. All right, guard, what are you guarding? What's so important over here?
Heard they're reforming the Dawn Guard. Vampire hunters or something in the old fort near Riften. Might consider joining up myself.
It'd be much better here or there than here. All right, so that's just an exit back out into Skyrim. Mistvale Keep.
The Greybeards have summoned the Dragonborn to High Hrothgar.
Yep, that would be
me. Such a thing has not happened for hundreds of years.
That's what I've heard. All right, so who's out here? We got some soldiers out here eating breakfast.
Take my advice. Don't listen to that talk of the face sculptor down in the Ragged Flagon. Face Butcher is more like it from what I've heard.
Okay. Talk to the face sculptor in the Ragged Flagon. Got it. All right, Lydia. Okay, we may have more people to talk to than I originally thought. Can I go in here?
Have our scouts come up with any information on these reports of dragons?
Yes, my lady. That unpleasantness at Helgen supposedly involved a dragon.
As Jarl Leila's houseguard, I would ask that you maintain respect and
distance from her at all times. I want you to speak to the city guard. Make sure there's a contingency plan in effect in case Riften falls under attack.
Yes, my lady. I've also taken the liberty in preparing a private carriage, just in case.
Good. If Riften should fall, it's only right that its leader be spared.
Ooh. I don't like you, nor did I expect to.
Welcome to Riften, traveler. I hope the road fared well for you.
It was all right. Listen, there's a lot of talk about the Thieves Guild in your town. What's your take on it?
We're all eager to see them brought to justice. Maven Blackbriar has assured me that they're being dealt with appropriately. As one of our city's most influential citizens, she's taken it upon herself to oversee their incarceration.
Really?
Sadly, they're proving elusive, but I have confidence that Maven won't give up until this city has been rid of them all.
Huh. Okay. I don't really care about your stance on the war, but I figure I'll ask, why not? What's your stance on the war?
While I feel Ulfric's cause is just, my concern is for the people of the Rift. How can they continue to lead their already meager lives with dark clouds looming overhead? My heart goes out to them. If only our coffers were deeper, I could protect them as they were my own family.
Interesting. What are your thoughts of Ulfric himself?
With the Stormcloaks at his back, Ulfric's poised to rid Skyrim of the Empire's forces and invalidate our involvement with the White Gold Concordat. Many have died taking up arms for this cause. I fear that the land will be stained with blood for years to come.
Hmm. What's this White Gold Concordat that you bring mention of?
Surely you're aware of the great war between the Imperials and the Elves who called themselves the Eldmeri Dominion? When the smoke cleared, the White Gold Concordat was signed. It was supposedly a treaty aimed at establishing peace within the Empire.
Hmm.
One of the terms of the treaty was the outlawing of worship to Talos. To the Stormcloaks, this was viewed as the moment when the Empire became unworthy of the allegiance of any true Nord.
Interesting. All right, maybe...
Good journey to you.
Maybe you're not so bad. I just think you're... I don't really know what to think of you. Hello?
Oh, come to gloat, have we? To poke fun at the Jarl's youngest son?
No, why? No! Why would I do that?
Because I did something not a soul in this blood-stained house of war has the backbone to do. Dared to speak my mind.
Oh.
I dared speak of the Empire and the lies that have been spread by Ulfric, the leader of the Stormcloaks. Now my mother stripped me of my heritage and incarcerated me here like a common criminal, and my brother has all but disowned me. Be wary what you say around here, friend. You'll find not all take kindly to insurrection.
Interesting. What sort of lies has Ulfric been spreading?
Ulfric only cares about one thing. Ulfric. He's ordained himself the future High King of Skyrim, and steps on anyone that gets in his way. He's begun a rebellion against those that wish to eradicate the worship of Talos, and uses it as his rallying cry. His cause may be true, but the man is a lie. All he holds in his heart is lust for the throne.
But... His cause may be true, but he himself is a lie? That doesn't make any sense, dude.
Mm-hmm.
Alright, we got a guard.
What
who's this over
it
here?
Mean? The return of the
Harold!
Out of my way. The son of the Jarl has no time for idle conversation with travelers.
Alright, you're gonna talk to me like that, I'm gonna have some snark to you too. Only a dagger for the son of a Jarl?
If you must know... I was practicing in the yard when the guard I was sparring with fainted when I specifically told him to duck. My blade bit right into the stonework next to the keep and needed serious repairs. Thankfully, our smith Balamond works wonders. In fact, if you'd fetch my blade from him, I'd be most appreciative.
Yeah, sure, I'll get it for you.
Thank you. Do hurry, please.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, you're lucky if I even bring it back.
Mm-hmm.
By the gods, it's
I don't
true,
really want to talk
it?
To you anymore.
A dragon has...
Alright, I'm thirsty. Let's get a drink real quick. Alright, anybody over here? Nope. What is that? Just a door. Oh, books. Books. I like books. Ooh, those are pretties. The dowry. Okay. What's that there? A quick note regarding my son, Sibby. He's to be treated as I'd expect you to treat any one of the Blackbriar family and all of his requests are to be honored without question. However, if he wishes to be released, you are not to do so unless I expressly authorize it. Sibby needs to learn his place, and the only way that will happen is if he's kept under lock and key. Yeah, that poor kid. I was going to say, he's incarcerated in this giant castle. That poor soul. All right, how about you? What's your name?
If you know any true sons and daughters of Skyrim, tell them to head to Windhelm. Ulfric Stormcloak wants to see them.
I'm thinking about it.
Keep your eyes open.
Oh, I guess I've talked to you before. Why are they called... Well, yeah, why are you called Stormcloaks? That's a good question.
At first, they called us that to belittle our cause. But we gladly accept being named for Ulfric Stormcloak, the only true High King of Skyrim. We are the true sons and daughters of Skyrim, and Ulfric. He is the truest of us all. We fight to make our land great once more, to raise up strong, noble thanes, and lay low false jarls and the cowards who hide behind them. The sound of our fury is a storm about to break on the heads of our enemies. Our friendship, a cloak of true brotherhood for all who would wear it.
Cool. All right, that's good to know. Who's pulling out a sword? Whoa! What's up?
Next Imperial I see is
what are you
dead.
Doing? Why do you have your blade out?
Talos guide you.
Out of my way. The son of the Jarl has
all
no
right,
time for
I'm just trying to figure out why your dagger's out, man.
Damn faithless right, Imperials.
It kind of scares me, to be quite honest with you. This place is pretty neat. Oh, look at the bears, the bear head. Nice. Iron battle axe. Okay. So what's out here? Mistvale Keep Barracks. Okay. Guess it's nap time. My goodness. Which one of you killed that? Alright, so we've got an upstairs to go look at. Probably should have finished the downstairs first. Okay, this is truly a barracks. Nothing really particularly
Riften,
special.
Home of the Thieves Guild.
It goes to
or so they'd have you believe. Mm-hmm. It's all lies. They're just thugs. They're
just thugs. Well, that's I would agree with that. All right, that's also to Riften. Okay, so let's use the top exit. I'm just curious where that actually takes me to. Where was that? Right. Okay. Cool. This little walkway over here. All right, and that's where that other exit is. Okay, so I guess we did explore all that. Lydia, do you mind jumping? Come on, Lydia, we can do this. This will be fun. Come on. One, two, three. Sorry. There we go. All right, come on down, Lydia. Chicken. So we've got, there's a back place. A back place. There's a rear area. This is a closed off gate, I take it. It's interesting. Oh, you're praying. I'll leave you be. There's a gate here with a lock. Lydia, watch my back. Got it. You know what? I don't really feel so bad about this because I don't trust anyone in this town. Blackbriar Manor. Well, okay then. The question is, are we welcomed or unwelcomed guests? I don't really see anybody around. There's some notes over here, though. Letter from Kristoff. Dearest Maven, after our disagreement a fortnight ago, I feared that business had finally gotten the best of our friendship. Since I still have yet to receive a reply to my last letter, it seems my suspicions are correct. I realize my mistake has cost you a lot, and all I hope to do is make amends. I'll be staying at the Bannered Mare in Whiterun should you wish to speak with me. Okay. And what about this one? Letter from Sabjorn. Maven, this is the final letter I'll be sending to you. I'm sick to death of your underhanded methods. A little competition never hurt anyone, and Hunting Brew has barely scratched the surface of your business. I've lost 2 more shipments this month to these so-called bandits. If I find out you're involved, I'm taking it to the Jarl. Okay. Those were to Maven, right? Okay, so this is Maven's room. I've been hearing a lot about Maven. I'm honestly not really super keen on being in her house, let alone her bedroom. But I see books to read. And I must read them. Okay. Okay, I take it everybody's out and about in this household. Let's go downstairs and see. I don't see anybody. I don't hear anybody. Regarding your loss. Lady Maven Blackbriar, I've made inquiries into the loss of your mead shipments to Cyrodiil, and I've come to the conclusion that they were waylaid by a group of mercenaries under the employ of the Empire. According to my sources, these mercenaries were not acting under orders, and simply attacked the caravan for supplies. I forwarded a request for your compensation on your behalf of the Imperial Council, and the mercenaries in question have already been dealt with accordingly. Again, I wish to extend my deepest apologies for this unfortunate mishap, and I assure you that any future shipments into our nation will be met at the border by an Imperial patrol and personally escorted to their final destination. Regin Limulus, Grand Steward, Imperial City Trade Relations. Got it. Oh, there's someone in here. Hello.
Fancy yourself the adventuring type, eh? It's just as well. I doubt your combat prowess would prove valuable in a real battle anyway.
What?
I was trained by some of the finest warriors in all Skyrim to wield a blade as if it was an extension of my own arm.
Gotcha. I kind of tried to do the same myself, to be honest. All right, let's see what's going on downstairs. Okay, got some alchemy going on down here. Oh, this one's locked. All right, I don't want to do that so close to him up there. But truth be told, he didn't seem very interested in me. Let's just take a peek. Got it. Okay. Whoa. A kiss, sweet mother. Do you wish to summon the Dark Brotherhood? You wish to see someone dead. Okay. To the Brotherhood. Astrid, I thought your people were supposed to be reliable. I've performed the Black Sacrament, I've paid the proper penance, and I've waited patiently for results. If you can't handle a simple assassination, I'll find someone who can. I want this contract handled, and I want it handled immediately. Maven Blackbriar. Whoa. Alright, let's get out of here, Lydia. Let's get out of here. Okay, remind me never to trust the Blackbriars. Also, don't try to cross their path too much. So is this a little cemetery? Got it. Ooh, nightshade. Don't mind if I do. I'd like to go check out this upper path up here. Seems interesting. So what is this now? Oh, okay, there's like an inner courtyard. Temple of Mara. Okay. What about you? Look, it requires a key. Interesting. Okay, well, let's head down here, take a look. Alright, so we're on this side of the market now. Okay. Got Got it. Hall of the Dead. Not somewhere I'm really interested in going. How about you? Requires a key. Excuse me, Lydia. All right, well, let's go back to where we were. Keep going around the outside. Nice little pathways over here. Okay, now where does this go? Oh, Hall of the Dead. That's right. I already looked at that. Oh, wait. I've already been this way. I needed to go further around. Right? Is there a further around? Yes, there is. Just want to make sure I don't miss anything before we leave this place. Oh. They really don't want us getting in there, do we? That's interesting. Of course, there's a guard here when I'm wanting to look at all this stuff. Don't mind me, sir. Don't mind me. What's that up there? Oh, there's like a mechanism. That's interesting. All right, let's go see what this place is at the front. Oh, is this a locked gate too? Now, why is this one locked? I can just go around it. That doesn't make a whole lot of sense. Oh, is this one locked too? No, this one opens. Oh, opens that way. Okay. So what's this here? Bully's house? Aaron's house? Snowshod Manor. Okay. That's locked. Riftwield Manor. This is open. Oh, door's barred from the other side. What? Lydia? This is one strange town. It's actually kind of making me miss Falkreath. Let's head back to Falkreath and let me get this stinking ring off my finger.